everyone, I'm Missy Lane and you're watching 5-Minute Bedtime Stories. I hope you're snuggled down and cozied up like I am, getting ready for bed or for nap time. I'm surrounded tonight by my stuffed animal friends and my cozy pig slippers. Do you like them? Maybe you have a favorite pair of slippers at home? Do you? I have my piggy slippers on today and I want to read you one of my favorite bedtime stories entitled Bed Hogs. You know, hog is another word for a pig. Did you know that? Bed hogs. In Sioux, South Dakota, in a sloppy, stuffy sty, there's an itchy old straw bed where the bed hogs pile high. Do you see them all squished in the barn? All stacked up one on top of each other? Of course, the mama and the papa take up lots of space in bed, and so do sisters Rose and Flo and Big Blue Ribbon Ed. Each night the hogs pack into bed, they squeeze and groan and grunt, but underneath the ton of them squeals loudmouth little Runt. Look at him down there, the little one. He's so squished. He's on the bottom of the pile. I'm squished. I'm squashed. I'm buried in this heap. You're hogging up my space in bed. I'll never get to sleep. Poor little Runt. Rose, the reigning beauty queen, is tender, pink, and sweet. But more than just a pretty face, Rose has some stinky feet. Pew! Look, her feet are right in little Runt's face. Runt gave sweet Rose a little shove and she tumbled out of bed. That left 5 hogs in the pile. Runt snuggled in and said, ah, much better. He looks more comfy cozy now, doesn't he? Until big sister Flo's a tidy hog, groomed neat from head to tail. But late at night, she drools enough to fill a milking pail. Ew, she's slobbering right on little Runt's face. Yuck. Runt gave big Flo a little push and she slipped right out of bed. That left 4 hogs in the pile. Runt snuggled in and said, much better. Brother Ed is quite a ham. His jokes give him the giggles. But when he has a funny dream, the hog bed shakes and jiggles. Stop! He's even laughing in his sleep. He's dreaming of something funny. Runt tickled Ed behind the ear. He laughed right out of bed. That left 3 hogs in the pile. Little Runt snuggled in and said, much better. He's relaxing now, look. He's comfy. Mama dances in her sleep. She spins and twirls and hops, but all that fancy footwork means a swift kick in the chops. Ouch! Uh-oh. Runt swung his mama round and round and she two-stepped off the bed. That left 2 hogs in the pile. Runt snuggled in and said, much better. He has a lot of room now, doesn't he? It looks like it's just him and who? Probably his papa. You think that's Papa Pig? Papa hardly moves at all. He's still as fleas and muck. But from his snout, there comes a snore that rumbles like a truck. Runt sprinkled fresh black pepper into Papa's noisy snout. That sneezing really did the trick, because Papa Hog fell right out. Now there was 1 hog in the bed. Just 1 sleepyhead. No mama, no papa, no sisters, no Ed. Runt hunkered down beneath the straw, down there in the stack. He closed his eyes and he hollered loud, hey, you guys, come back. Aw, first he was too squished, but then he became too lonely. He didn't want to sleep in the straw bed all by himself. He missed them. Come back. I'm cold. I'm scared. I'm lonely in this heap. Without y'all hugging up the bed, I'll never get to sleep. So all the hogs came running and hopped back into bed. Mama, Papa, Rose and Flo, and Big Blue Ribbon Ed. In Sioux, South Dakota, in an itchy old straw bed, The bed hogs piled high again. Runt snuggled in and said, "Ah, much better." Well, I hope you enjoyed tonight's bedtime story called Bed Hogs. We're going to end with Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. I made this little prop from home just by cutting out a yellow star, gluing it on a black piece of construction paper, and then you guessed it, I taped it to a popsicle stick or a tongue depressor. They can be fat or skinny. If you didn't have one of those at home, you could use a ruler or even a straw. So you can make one of these too. We're going to put our twinkle star up in the air. And will you sing it with me? Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Very good. And then I'm going to flip my paper around to the other side, and then you'll see a moon, right? And you can cut out a moon shape so that yours is double-sided. We'll have our star and then our moon. I see the moon and the moon sees me. God bless the moon and God bless me. Good night, everybody. God bless. I'll see you next time.